Warm welcome to Bethlehem Matriculation Higher Secondary School online class. I am Binila, your English teacher. Okay, now let me go for the lesson poem. That is Once Upon a Time, is written by Gabriel O'Hara. What is the heading of the poem? Once Upon a Time by Gabriel O'Hara. Okay, so this is the first poem in this 11th grade. You don't have any memory poem, so you don't have to memorize this. Okay, now let me go tell about Gabriel O'Hara. He was born on 25th April 1921 and died on 25th March 2019. It is the last year he died. And he is a Nigerian poet and novelist. He is considered to be one of the first modern African poets. As he is a Nigerian, he is an African poet. He is considered as one of the modern African poets he is considered to be. And the next, his verse has been translated into several languages. So as it is, he is a popular poet, his verses has been translated into many languages. And his works that is appeared in the magazine Black or Fierce from 1957. So he started his writings, everything, and it was published. So whenever you wanted to write a poem, it will be published in the local magazines. So here, his work, it was published in Black or Fierce. That is, in the year 1957, it was published. And he got many awards also. That is the award for literature at the Nigerian Festival Awards in 1953. And the poem he has written, The Call of the River Nun. So other works also, his first novel is The Voice, that is the linguistic experiment he has done. And other more works, what he has done is the collection of poems it is written, The Fisherman Invocation, that is it is written in the year 1978. And two books for children, that is Little Snake and Little Frog, that also it is written in 1981. Another one work, An Adventure of Juju Island, that is in 1992. So about the writer, let me read. Take your textbook, page number 22. About the author, take it. Okay, now let me read. Listen. Gabriel O'Hara, born in 1921, is a Nigerian poet and novelist. His verse has been translated into several languages. And his poem, The Call of the River Nun, won the Best Award for Literature at the Nigerian Festival of Arts in 1953. Some of his poems were published in the influential periodical Black or Fierce, and by 1960 he established himself as an accomplished writer. He was honored with the Commonwealth Poetry Award. O'Hara's typical poem transits from everyday reality to the moments of delight and moves back to reality, making a complete circle. O'Hara infused African thought, folklore and imagery into both his verse and prose. His first novel, The Voice, is an outstanding linguistic experiment. His later works include a collection of poems, The Fisherman's Invocation, that is in the year 1978, and two books for children, Little Snake and Little Frog in 1981 and Adventure to Juju Island in 1992. So about the author, you came to know that. Let me move on to the poem. Take page number 20. Take the poem. Once Upon a Time. So have you heard of this heading, Once Upon a Time? Yeah, when somebody is narrating a story, you might have heard that once upon a time, there is a lion, there was a king. So this all type of story when they are telling, the fairy tale when they are telling, they will be starting with the heading, Once Upon a Time. Okay, so now this heading, Once Upon a Time, you came to understand that it is related to the past event. Okay. So now here the writer, he wants to tell about his past and he wants to compare with the present. So comparing with the present life, he wanted to tell to the son. That is, the father to his son is the bond here. So already in the first lesson we have seen the writer Khushwant Singh, that is the relationship between the grandmother and the writer, is it? Okay, so here we are going to see the relationship between the narrator and the listener, is the father and son. Okay, so now let me move on to the warm up. Guess what friendly words these two gentlemen exchanged when shaking hands. So there is a picture about two persons, they are shaking their hands. Okay, so you can imagine what friendly words are, casually they will be talking to each other. What are the words they will be using here? Okay, so one person will be telling, "Hi, you are very happy to see you," or "very glad to meet you," one person will be telling. So other person also will be telling, "Yeah, I am happy to meet you too." So the relationship between the two, it shows that they are very happy. But are you sure that they are very happy to meet each other? Sometimes we will be meeting our friends, so we will be very happy to meet them, and wholeheartedly we will be saying, "Very happy to meet you." Some other friends, they are not your friends, they may be your relatives, you are not happy to see them, but what you will be saying, by seeing them, you will be saying, "Yeah, I am happy to see you." Yeah, that is the difference between their friends and relatives. Even you are not happy, you are telling, conveying the words, "I am happy to see you." Yes, this is the reality and the past what you are telling to the other persons only is there in the lesson, in the poem. Okay, now let me tell you the next one. The children in the picture are watching an exciting sporting event where their school team is winning. Suggest suitable utterance reflecting their feelings. See, the children, they are playing. In the picture you can see that is very happy moment they are expressing that. So one person will be telling, "Hooray, our team has won the match." So very happy they are. So the expression is real. Their happiness is real. Okay, so this is the relationship between the real life and the past, which you don't show the happiness. Okay, so next one is given. Given a chance, any adult would wish to become a child again for many reasons. Fill the boxes with some of what you imagine could be the reasons. So example, it is given, "I need not worry about project deadlines." So when you are imagine that you are a child and you have many reasons to be happy, here one reason is given, "I need not worry about any project deadlines." So now also you are at home, you don't want to worry about any project or any homework, you can be very free. That is the happiest moment you have. So next one is, "I can wear my pyjamas the whole day." So you are happy, you don't want to wear any your uniform. You can be very happy in your casual dress. So this is the very happiest one for you. The next one, "I can sleep as long as I like." This is the very happiest one for everyone. So as long as you like, you can sleep. Nobody will disturb you. Nobody, your parents will never wake up you for get up, go to school. Like that, they will never say. So this is the happiest. So in the other boxes also you can write what are the other things you feel. Some persons will feel, "I have to play always in my mobile. I have to enjoy in playing games in the laptop." This is all the things. So such things you can write. What is the happiest things you are wishing to do? That everything you can write it up. You can fill it up in the boxes given. Okay. Now move on to the poem. Take page number 21. Children acquire important life skills and values by observing and imitating grown-ups like parents or teachers. Can it be the other way round? Now you are going to listen to the poem, "Once Upon a Time," where a parent wants to learn something from the son. Let's find out how. So now here already I told you that this is the relationship between the narrator and the listener. Who is the narrator here? Father. Who is the listener? Son. So here the father is narrating the poem to his son, past event, what he has felt, and now in the present life, what are the changes are there, that he is telling to his son is a poem here. And now many people, you will be looking into the small kids, you might have seen, always they will be imitating others. That is, you may have your younger sister or brother, you may have. So then what they will be doing, they will be seeing the elder one and they will be imitating to do some activities. What they wanted to do, this is everything they will be doing. So here they are going to see about the parents and teachers, and they will be imitating. In the house, they will be playing like taking the stick, and they will be acting like a teacher. I am your teacher, please listen, like that. Small children or small kids, they will be acting. Or like your parents, I am your mother, obey my words, like that they will be telling. So like this, you might have seen many things, but in the reverse you go for. That small kids, they are imitating the parents or teachers. Reverse you go for, the parents or teachers or the elder person, they wanted to go or they wanted to look back to their olden days. That is their small childhood days they wanted to look into. So imagine that, how it will be. So always you as a higher classes students, what you will be doing, you will be telling that in olden days, in 10th standard or in my childhood days, I was very happy, I was enjoying very well, I was playing, I was running here and there, nobody used to scold me. These are all the things you will be telling. So like that, you will be happy about your childhood days. So now you are going to see that the author, that is the writer, Gabriel Okara, that is a narrator, the father, he is going to tell about his own experience in his childhood days, in olden days, how it was. So as he is a Nigerian poet, he is going to bring a change, a modern culture to the African society. He is going to tell that before the cultural changes comes into the society, how the society was. Okay, so when there is a cultural change in the society, everything has changed. In olden days, the dress wearing was different, but in the modern days, the dress, what they dress code, everything is changed. So like that, the writer is going to tell to his son, in olden days, we was happy, we was laughing wholeheartedly, we was enjoying all the things, but now we are not happy. The people who is laughing is not happy, laughing with their heart. They are just smiling, they are just showing their teeth, so they are not wholeheartedly laughing. So this one only is there in the poem, Once Upon a Time. Here? Okay, now let me tell about the poem here. Once Upon a Time is a free verse of poem containing 43 lines are there in this poem and broken up into 7 stanzas. How many stanzas? There are 7 stanzas. Free verse means there is no limit for the stanzas or lines. This many lines, a poem contains, a paragraph should be contain 4 lines or like that. It is not there. It is a free verse. That is a 43 lines and the stanzas is, it is 7 stanzas. It is them. Okay, I already told you it is not a memory poem. You don't have any memory poem in your grade 11 and 12. Okay, are you happy for that?
Yeah.
Okay, now let me move on to the lesson. The theme of the lesson is how the society changes or the cultural shift. What it has done is a theme in this poem. Okay, take your book, page number 21. And now let me go for the reading the first paragraph and let me explain you. Okay, once upon a time, son, they used to laugh with their hearts, but what is happening? Once upon a time, I told you, it is says about the olden days. He's telling to his son, once upon a time, what they will be doing? They used to laugh with their hearts. So wholeheartedly, with warmth, they are laughing. They, with every emotion, with eyes, everything, it shows the pleasure, the happiest moment they have. So with that happiness, it will come as a smile and they will be showing the smile. And laugh with their eyes. How they are laughing? The happiness, it will shows, the warmth, it will shows in their eyes. So when we are seeing some eye contact, we can feel that they are really, they are talking the truth or they are telling lie. We can identify that. So in olden days, what they was doing, they was showing their smile with the wholeheartedly, with their eyes. But now they only laugh with their teeth also. But now what they are doing, now at present moment, the people, they are laughing with the fake laugh, that is laughing without any emotion. They don't have any emotion, just they laugh. And while their eyes block cold eyes, eyes block cold eyes means, eyes block cold eyes, that is eyes lacking a feeling of warmth. So some comfortable feeling. This everything is lacking in their eyes. So this is called eyes long, cold eyes. Okay. So search behind my shadows. So they cannot identify their real emotion. So just they will be searching where they have the happiness. So they cannot feel the real emotion there. So this is the first stanza. So here the poet wanted to say to his son, once upon a time son, and they used to laugh with their hearts, and now they are laughing with their only with their teeth. That is the fake laugh they have. They don't have the real one. And eyes block cold eyes. Their eyes are lacking the feeling, or they are comfortable, or the warmth it is lacking them. And search behind my shadow. So everyone, they are searching behind my shadow. That is the comfortable or the real one, they are searching behind me. And the next paragraph, second paragraph. There was a time indeed. So which does exist? There was a time which does exist. They used to shake hands with their hearts. So what the people used to do? When they meet each other, they will shake their hands with pleasure and warmth. Very happiness, they will be shaking their hands. So whenever we are meeting some persons, we will be shaking their hands with very happy, yeah, hi, hello, how are you? So this all the things we will be saying. But nowadays it is not needed to shake hands. As it is Corona, you don't want to shake the hands to each other. It is not needed. But that's gone, son. So here he's telling, so in olden days, they was having a comfortable to meet each other. They'll be having a handshake with comfortably. But now everything has gone, my son. So he's telling to his son, those days everything has went. And it is not here. It is not comfortable now. Those habits, everything gone. Now they shake hands without hearts. So how they are doing nowadays, they are greeting each other without any warmth. They don't have any comfortable. They never shake their hands with their hearts. While their left hand search my empty pockets. So if nowadays what is happening, when each person is shaking their hands, the other person is looking into the other one. How they are looking into? Whether he is having a comfortable wealth and he is having money, they are searching into the other's pocket. So whether he is good at everything, they are looking when they are shaking the hands. In olden days, how they will be shaking their hands? They will never see anything. They will see the happiest moment alone. They will be sharing each other. But nowadays, when they are shaking the hands, what they are doing? They are looking into the other's pocket, whether he is having enough wealth or not. And when he is calculating how he would be exploit this, everything he is calculating, and then only he is shaking the hands off. And next paragraph. Feel at home, come again, they say. And when I come again and feel at home once, twice, there will be no thrice. For them, I find doors shut on me. So now feel at home. What is the meaning of feel at home? Yeah, you are feeling very comfortable. So where you will be feeling very comfortable? At home. Yeah, it is true. So very comfortable, feel at home means somebody is telling them, feel at home, come again. You have to come to my house again and again. You have to come, they say. But when the person is going to their home, they feel comfortable. That is once. First time they will be feeling comfortable once. Twice. The second time also they are okay. But the third time what they are doing, they are not feeling comfortable. So there is a proverb, there is a says in the olden days, the people, they will be inviting guests to their house. And the first day they will be giving a lot of food for them. That is a variety of foods they will be serving for the guests. And the second day the food serving which will be reduced up. Okay, they will never be much comfortable of serving the food or giving the comfortable for the guests. The third day they will be normal. They will not be overjoyed with the arrival of the guest. So like the same thing here, when somebody is coming to my house or some coming to the house, what they will be doing? They will be feeling comfortable for the first day. First day they will be okay. The second day also it is okay. But the third time when they are coming, they are ready to come to their house. For then I find doors shut on me. So the third time, if the guests again and again they are coming to their place, what they will do? They will shut the door. They will never allow the persons to come again. So here you might have seen your relatives also. When some person is coming again and again to your house, so what you will do? You will not feel much happy of them. You will be shutting the doors. Whether you will be shutting the doors? No. Okay, you are good children. Okay, so that he is telling that in olden days they will be welcoming us very well, but now they are not welcoming. First day they will be welcoming, second day they will welcome, but the third time they will shut the door. And if you are a frequent visitor, they will be closing the doors up. Next, we will move on to the fourth paragraph. So I have learned many things, son. I have learned to wear many faces, like dresses, home face, office face, straight face, host face, cocktail face, with all their conforming smiles, like a fixed portrait smile. So how they are? I have learned many things. So you also might have learned many things. Okay, in your life you have learned many things. What you have learned? You have learned what is given in your book, what is in your real life experience you may have. So this everything what you are doing, you have learned, you have experienced, or you have took it into your mind. Okay, so here what he has learned is, I have learned to wear many faces. Many faces means you also know that how to behave to the teacher, how to behave to your mother, how to behave to your parent or your father, how to behave to your younger one or elder one. So when you want money, you will be going to your mother. When you want to go outside and enjoy, you will be calling your father. And so you know to act very well. If there is a teacher, you will be very quiet. If there is no teacher in the class, you will be showing all your naughty. So like this, you have a different face, right? Yeah. You will be doing lot of different faces you have. So here he is telling this writer, that is a narrator, he knows very well, he learned very well to show different faces. That is, what are the faces he is known to show is, the poet learned to show act according to the situation. What is this? Like dresses. So how you are going to the party, you have a different dress. You have some other cultural programs, or you can wear different dress. To marriage house, you have your traditional dress. So like this, how you are able to change your dresses according to the situation, like that, the poet also learned to change his face, that is the mask of his face, he learned to change according to the situation. Like dresses, home face, when he is at home, how he has to behave, everything he understood, he learned everything. And in at office, what he has to do, he has to show different faces. He cannot be very liberal like the how he was at home. The same way he cannot be at the office. He has to be very strict. His face has to be like a leadership power has to be come to his face. So he has to change his face. And straight face, when he's moving to the street, he cannot be like a leader. He has to move according to the ordinary person. So that should be have a different changes according to the places. And a host face, that is treating the guest. Host means treating, how you'll be treating the guest. So when the guest is there, what you have to do? You have to laugh at them. You have to treat them very well. You cannot be angry towards them like when you are at home. So that is a different between the places, or the different between the situation you have to act. Cocktail face. So cocktail face is here mixed emotion. What is the meaning of cocktail face? Mixed emotion. Okay. So here, when you are going to have a different face, that is office face, street face, house face, home face, and cocktail face. That is, you have all the emotion in a mixed way with all their conforming smiles. So how you are having all these faces in a conforming smiles, wearing a standard, desirable or artificial smile on all occasion. You are having in a, every time you are wearing a mask in your face like a smile. So how you'll be smiling, the happiest moment you'll be showing to the others, the same way you will be doing. So like a fixed portrait smile. So in the portrait means in a picture. So when you are going for taking a photograph, what you will do, you will smile. Okay. So always the picture in the photo, it will be, it shows that you are smiling. So there is no changes in your photograph. Like that, how it is, like a fixed portrait smile, like a painting, the people is having a smile in their face, in all the places, in all the cocktail face, that is a mixed emotion they have. Okay, the next paragraph. And I have learned to laugh with only my teeth. So now he has learned to laugh with his teeth. That is the fake laugh. Okay. So till now he was telling in the olden days how they was. They was shaking their hands with the happiest. Wholeheartedly they was doing. And now they are, he is telling that he also learned to. What he has learned? How to shake the hands up with the without any emotion. That is to laugh with only my teeth. Understood to laugh. He also learned to laugh only showing the teeth, not emotionally, not happily. So he understood that. And shake hands without my heart. Now he understood that he can shake the hands without heart. That is without any emotion they are able to shake their hands. I have also learned to say goodbye when I mean good riddance. So when he is good riddance means the expression he is showing to being free. When he wanted to relaxation or being unwanted person is that you want to show it very relaxedly. So that time he was able to say goodbye. So when he wanted to say goodbye, what he is doing? He is able to show that emotion to the others. To say glad to meet you without being glad, and to say it has been nice talking to you after being bored. So he also learned to keep his real character a secret and shows the world a fake character. So what he's learned of previously, he was knowing that to show his emotion wholeheartedly, but now he learned a fake one, fake character he learned. So when you are child, you learn, you know that you was very innocent, but now when you are grown up, you started started to say lie, you started to be fake. So this is all the characters you have learned. The same way the writer is telling, you also he also learned to show his fake emotion. Okay, children, still two more paragraphs are there. We will be seeing in the next class. I will explain you that. Okay, thank you, students.